This card entitles the bearer to 1 year off. To take care of the world's most beautiful baby.
I crunched the numbers.
But how?
It doesn't matter how. I made it work.
Oh. I don't know what to say. I don't have to say anything.
Subject is queer as folk, and naturally, lesbians play a part as well. Let's meet our next panel. Here in Los Angeles, Scott Lowell. He plays Ted Schmidt. Ted is a gay, a low-key, down-to-earth accountant, who, by the way, he is also a straight man.
And not a lesbian.
Not a lesbian. Yeah. New York is Robert Gant. He plays Ben Bruckner. Ben was not part of the first season. He's a professor of gay studies, also is HIV positive, also is straight.
And two jury's straight, out on that one, actually.
Okay. Two straight ladies here in Los Angeles. Taya Gill, who plays Lindsay Patterson, a university professor in a committed lesbian relationship. And Michelle Clooney, who plays Melanie Marcus. Melanie is a tough lawyer in that committed lesbian relationship. Why did you take this part, Scott?
Mostly because of the character reminded me so much of myself in a certain stage of my life, especially moving out to Los Angeles from Chicago. The gay club scene that's portrayed in Queer as Folk is exactly what Los Angeles is like. It's a world where youth and beauty and wealth is prized, and if you don't have those things and you don't quite fit in, much as my character does, you end up on the rejected end of the post.
Robert, you know there are some people who are complaining that heterosexuals shouldn't have been cast at all. It should have been an all-gay cast. How do you react to that?
Well, I think at the end of the day, it's about who best portrays a part. I mean, the reality is that we know that Rock Hudson had been playing straight roles for how many years, and you know, this has been happening back and forth, you know, since the beginning of time. It's just, I guess now that the tables are turned, people are...
Yeah.
That
might be a good point. Taya, why'd you take it?
Yeah.
Well, I thought it was just a lovely role, and I felt very fortunate enough to be offered such a role. And I loved the emotional aspects of Lindsay and her relationship with her family and the traditional qualities.
Was it hard, though, to play that scene we just saw, making love to a woman, when I assume that you prefer men?
Oh, no, it was a breeze. Every time I'm working with Michelle, it's a joy.
Wait a minute, are you in love with Michelle now?
Of course I am.
Absolutely.
I love her.
I'll elope after this.
That's right.
No, was it hard to play that?
No, not at all. Not at all. It was very simple, and it was very rooted for me. And every time I work on any scene that I am in with Michelle and anyone else in the show.
No conflicts for you?
None.
Michelle, what about you?
Conflicts?
Yeah, and you are heterosexual.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
Any
yes,
difficulty?
Yes. No, it's just a part of the job, and to me, I see love as love. I don't think that I relate very much to the love that Melanie and Lindsay share, and it's very beautiful. And I think at the end of the day, you just, you know, it's wonderful to get to play a character that has such a strong point of view and is feisty, and that you don't get to see on TV very often.
How do you react to all the attention it's getting?
I think it's wonderful.
Even the bad, even those who are critical.
Well, you know, I don't really listen to those voices very much, you know, when people are critical. I think that if you listen to that, how do you get out of bed and create in the morning? I hear so much positive reinforcement that the critical voices, I don't know what you're talking about.
Is it hard, Scott, to play a love scene with a man?
No. I mean, although I do apologize to any woman I've kissed and given razor burn to over the years, that's the hardest part of it, I suppose, is needing a good moisturizer afterwards.
So that's, what's the hardest part? Robert, what's the hardest part for you about playing a gay person?
You know, I think, you know, at the end of the day, once again, acting is acting. And you know, our lives, the whole point is that there's no real difference, that we tend to focus on how we're not the same. And what people are noticing about the show is they're starting to see our similarities. They're starting to see how we're the same, how people, at the end of the day, love the same, they argue the same, they have sex very similarly. And so, really, as an actor, my job is to take my life experiences and to put them into the scene that I'm playing. I, you know, there was when I was having a love scene with or a romantic scene with Leah Thompson or with Lisa Kudrow, kissing them, you know, it's no different really than you know, kissing Hal, in that I'm not in love with any of these people. I'm, you know, looking inside of myself and finding those places where I remember being in love and
bringing
that into the
scene. Taya, the first time you had to kiss a woman, was that hard? Assuming it's something you'd never done.
No, same thing that Bobby was talking about. It's another human being. It's another
feel pair different.
It's softer and more gentle.
Oklahoma City, hello.
Yes, my mom and I are fans of the show, and we were wondering, for the straight actors, do they have appreciation for gay people now that they've portrayed them?
Good question. Has it changed your thinking at all, Scott?
No, I've always appreciated gay people. I've known many. I have some in my family. They are people just like any of us. There's, you know, as has been mentioned earlier, the only thing the Queer as Folk has taught me is how much we're all alike, and that all the fuss and the nonsense people make over the differences is absurd. We're all human beings.
Bob, has it changed you at all, feelings toward gay people?
You know, I'm just really proud to be a part of this. It's revolutionary in that there was a time when there was a show for the first time was about people of color, and it was controversial, and it caused people to talk and argue, and this show is doing exactly that. It's historic, and I'm just so excited to be a part of it and to watch the world changing. People don't realize what this is doing. It's opening minds and hearts and souls, and, you know, in the wake of September 11th, I think we're all, you know, taking a look at love and at life a lot differently.
Yeah. Affected you anyway, Taya?
Michelle,
I'm sorry.
To be part of it? Yeah, absolutely. I think going through the emotions that Melanie goes through as a character and being shut out of a hospital room and not being able to be with my baby and the woman that I love and having to go through that as an actress, it's made me even more compassionate. Where there already was compassion, it's so much deeper.
You've given us all a better understanding of the parts you play, and I thank you very much.
Thank you.
We're going to meet the executive producers and a critic of this extraordinary program. You're watching Larry King Live. Don't go away.
Oh, my God.
Say hello to your son.
Well, go on. When did it start?
Around 7.
6 hours later, there he was.
I wish I could have been here. How often do I get to see
Looks just like you.
I guess you must be mine then.